honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen. It certainly gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to this conference. And I must say, it's a special pleasure to see so many old friends and colleagues having taken time out to come here to Lisbon today. Thank you for that. I've often said there is more to quality shipping than clean certificates. Without a suitable legal framework and proper implementation and enforcement of the existing legislation, we pave the way for less responsible players and free riders jeopardizing safety, security, and the environment of the sea. The objective of AMSA is to ensure a high, uniform, and effective level of maritime safety and security, as well as prevention of pollution and response to pollution by ships in European waters. With this objective, and assisting member states and the Commission in performing their duties, EMSA has over the past 9 years developed to become a recognized, successful European institution playing a significant role in bringing European maritime administration to the front. The Commission's proposal on amending the EMSA founding regulation will further strengthen the role of EMSA, and I'm sure that EMSA stakeholders want to see the positive development of EMSA continue in the coming years. However, achieving the objectives of EMSA in today's and tomorrow's economic climate calls for new ways of thinking, calls for innovation and cost-effective solutions, cost-effective for the administrations and for the industry. This is why the words added value has been repeated over and over again at meetings of the EMSA Administrative Board, in the EMSA 5-year strategy, which the board adopted last year, and not least in discussions at political level in Council and Parliament on the proposed amendments to the EMSA founding regulation. The tasks of EMSA should reflect a sound burden sharing between work that is most efficiently dealt with by member states at national level and tasks that are most efficiently dealt with by EMSA assisting member states and the Commission. But what does sound burden sharing mean when we look into the future? There are no easy answers to this question, and it's important to listen to the views of EMSA stakeholders to find the proper answers. I'm therefore grateful that such distinguished speakers have volunteered to join us today and give us their input, their innovative contribution as to the evolution of EMSA's task. What task, existing as well as new ones, should be developed and add value in the coming years? How is EMSA's objective best achieved when we look into the future of European maritime administration? We all look forward to your interventions, and it's my sincere hope that today's conference will inspire us all to contribute to developing EMSA's task in a prudent way in the future. Shipping is international, and the international context must never be forgotten when we discuss safety, security, and protection of the marine environment. Europe depends on the international regulation of shipping through the IMO. It is in the IMO we meet our colleagues from other parts of the world and work together to find global solutions that the shipping industry must meet no matter where in the world. It's therefore with a very great pleasure that I, in a moment, can invite my friend through many years, the Secretary General of the IMO, Mr. Efthymios Mitropoulos, to give us the opening address at today's conference. Mr. Mitropoulos, needs no further introduction. We all know his commitment to ensure safe, secure, environmentally friendly shipping all over the world, and his excellent achievements as Secretary General of the IMO. Please, Secretary General, the floor is yours, and thank you for your attention. I wish you all a fruitful day.